episode I like to call Alexandria Ocasio Cortez is a lion horse face asshole. It's kind of like being a lion dog face pony soldier.
You're a lion dog face pony soldier.
But it's a lion horse face asshole. So, as you can see, the streets are painted red, white, and blue, and I am headed towards the freeway on 6th Street in Norco, which means that I am headed away from my moment of serenity with my horse. We got out, we played, I did a side job this morning in Norco, which was awesome because we were done in a couple of hours, got some hang time with my big brother, which is always nice, and still got out to ride my horse, and it's only 1:30. Actually, well, 1:20. Jeez Louise. So, you know, I had my moment of serenity. Now it's time to put the angry eyes back on.
Prepare to meet Mr. Angry Eyes.
Hold it! And talk about what is making America worse again. So, if you were wondering why Alexandria Ocasio Smollett was trending, it's because she completely lied about where she was or who was at her front door yelling at her during the insurrection. I'm always reminded of that scene from Office Space where they go, "Buck up in your ass with the resurrection."
Is the group harder than an erection that shows no affection? They want to ban us on Capitol Hill, cause it's die, motherfuckers, die, motherfuckers.
All along it was the ghetto, nothing but the ghetto. Taking short steps, 1 foot at a time, and kept my head low. And never let go, cause if I let go, then I'd be spineless. I'm going insane.
I think my mind just goes out of control and touch on subjects, motherfuckers, freedom. I touch on the shit that they be leaving out. I seen this motherfuckers not smoking. I seen this, I bet you motherfuckers will too. Because it's time, motherfucker, die, motherfucker, steal, fool.
I want it to be back up in your ass with the insurrection. Look, if you guys in Congress were doing your jobs, that kind of crap wouldn't happen. You wouldn't have, this has never happened in the history of, I don't know, in the recent history of the United States. I think that hasn't happened since the War of 1812. I think since 1814 when the British burned down the White House. I don't think that kind of thing has ever happened since. Does that tell you the political temperature of our country? Doesn't that make you go,
Things that make you go,
I don't know. I'm gonna put in a couple of memes here that I thought were hilarious about Alexandria Ocasio Smollett, and since it's one of those things that makes you go, we'll have that music playing underneath.
I was in the crib, sitting by the fireplace, drinking cocoa on the best game rug. Doorbell rang, who could it be? Thought to myself, then started to shrug. Got to the door, ding dong, who is it? My girl's best friend had paid me a visit. Fly as can be, tight dressed and all. She knew that I was faithful and really didn't have to go. I tried to chill, she made the move. Now I know my girlfriend wouldn't approve. I didn't realize my girl was setting me up. Yo, my girlfriend didn't trust me, no. Yup, but she lost control, I wouldn't take the bait. I said, chill, baby, baby, chill, baby, baby, wait. My girl bust in, caught us creating the boom. She said,
girlfriend, things to make you
things that make you go. The brother
gotta get trampled, ruin your life, sleep with your wife, watch your behind. There was a friend of mine named Jay, would come over late at night to say, hey, I watched your fight, I thought it was alright, cause me and Jay, we were really, really tight, so damn close, we're the same blood type.
So, why does Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez feel the need to lie to everybody about where she was or what happened, and then she's like telling everybody that, oh my god, I was afraid for my life because the Capitol Police officer looked concerned for her well-being, but she was like, he looked angry at me. No, he wasn't looking angry at you. He was like, you know, I have to save your life. We need to go in case they come this way. Now, she was a third of a mile away from where everything was happening. Which, if any of you know how long a quarter of a mile is, remember in high school and junior high when you had to run around the track that went around the football field? Jeep guy with angry eyes! Dig it! That track is a quarter of a mile. Remember, if you ran like as fast as you could to get all the way around, maybe you're around in the 2 minute mark. Now imagine that plus, I don't know, maybe a third of a lap, you know, maybe past the finish line and then run all the way up to the corner and a little bit, and that's what a third of a mile is. So you're looking at basically 2.5-3 minutes. If they all ran full sprint towards AOC's office and they knew exactly where it was, didn't have to open up any doors, you know, worst possible case scenario, bazooka through the side of the wall, boom, right at her. She had at least 3 minutes because she was watching it live on TV like the rest of us. So if one person said, hey, we already bazooka'd a hole in AOC's wall to her office, we can just run full sprint. And then what? It's gonna take them like 5-6 minutes to get their breath back after they sprint that, you know, 2.5-3 minutes. How are we gonna get there? Be like, we came here to kill you, but hang on a second. Give us a couple minutes. Catch our breath. That's a long run. We're carrying flags. We're wearing furs. This stuff is heavy. Hang on. AOC, if you want to stick around, give us 3-4 minutes, catch our breath, we're gonna kill you. No, you fucking idiot! You lying, horse face asshole! Like that guy said, hey Trump, China is asshole!
What's your message to, have you seen Donald Trump? Do you think he should step in?
Donald Trump, don't trust China. China is asshole.
It's like that. AOC, you are asshole. Now, obviously, that's not a sound clip when I play AOC. That's not what she sounds like. That's just what she looks like. That's what my horse sounds like. But you have to admit,
you know, well, I'm a chicken fried, a cold beer on a Friday night, a pair of jeans that fit just right, and a radio.
The similarities between her and Batman are pretty irrefutable. Anyway, I just like showing clips of my horse, any excuse I get. So anyway, I hope that you enjoyed the memes as much as I did. I had a wonderful time out with my horse. You know, AOC's a freaking liar. She's been a liar since day one. I hope that you enjoyed the video. I hope that you have a wonderful Super Bowl weekend. And I will see you next time. Bye.
I'm packing you an extra pair of shoes and your angry eyes, just in case. And if you get hungry, here's some cheese puffs. sure, but you never need a golf ball, if you have time for golf, and a plastic steak, and a rubber ducky, and a yo-yo, and an extra bouncy, bouncy ball, and some extra teeth. Be careful, they chatter.
Whoa!
And crayons, in case you get bored, and some blue Play-Doh. And a dime, call me, and monkey chow.
Monkey chow? For what?
Well, for the monkeys, of course. Come on, monkey.
That's it. I draw the line at monkeys. Get my agent on the phone.